viewers, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you enjoyed the last video. Thank you very much for the subscription and also for sharing our videos. Before we proceed with today's class, I will encourage you to please try to click on the subscription button and also to share our videos. Thank you very much. Now today, in our first class, we'll be having a number-based system. Like I said in the previous video, the topics in which we'll be teaching in this channel have been listed in the description page. So you can click on it and see the list of topics that will be treated. So our first topic will be on the number-based system. So when we talk about the word number-based system, we are very used to number in base 10, number in base 2, which is also known as the binary number, and the number in base 10 as the decimal number. Most of the numbers we are used to are numbers in base 10, because every number given to you is assumed to be in base 10. If I ask you what is your age, and you tell me I am 15 years old, I assume it is in base 10. So one of the things we need to know is that when we talk about binary number, when we talk about what binary number? Binary number are numbers in base 2. This is commonly used for people in the computer science department, because binary numbers are assumed to only have 2 digits. There's one thing about this number based system. For every base given to you, the number of digits required must not be up to the base system, up to the base, or greater than the base. For example, you are given a number in base 2, which is known as a binary number. So it is assumed that all the digits that number in base 2 must have must not be greater than 0 and 1. Must not be greater than what? 0 and 1. So if the number is in base 3, the value it can assume cannot exceed 0, 1, 2. As you can see, this is in base 2 and it has 2 digits. And if you look at these 2 digits, we have 0 and 1. None of the digits is up to the base, neither is it greater than the base. The same thing is applicable here. We have this in base 3. If you look at the digits we have 0, 1, and 2. So none of these digits is up to this base, neither is it greater than it. So if we continue like this, up to number in base 9. So number in base 9 can only have 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 8. Yes. Up to 8. So it must not be up to 9, neither should it be greater than 9. That is why most of the times we have number in base 10. Number in base 10 is assumed to be 1, 2, 3, up to 9. The moment you have 10, this is no longer a digit. You have 2 digits. This combination of 2 numbers now, 2 digits. So that means that for a number based system, it should neither be greater nor equal to the number base system. So it should be 1 less than the number base system. Now, what are we going to do? We have to look at the situation whereby we convert from base 10 to base 2. And also, the second situation is when we want to convert from base 2 to base 10. The third scenario is when we want to convert from other bases aside from base 2 to base 10. And the last scenario is when we want to convert from base 10 to other bases before we move to the basic arithmetic regarding number based system. Follow me. So, the first thing we are going to do is converting. Binary number to is 10.
Amen.
I believe you understand what I mean by binary number. When I say binary number, it means I'm referring to numbers in base 2. When you have a binary number, for example, I'm going to give you an example. Convert the following to base 10. So under this, it's going to have some questions. We have 1101 in base 2. The second question, we have 1110 in base 2. We want to convert this to base 10. If you look at this, for the first question, solution, we have 1101 in base 2. We want to convert to number in base 10. You see, there's one thing about something interesting about this number base system in base 2. Majorly in computer, most of this programming only decode binary numbers, which is 0 and 1. So at times, if they want to convert it to a basic information, okay, you have to do what is known as conversion. So here we are converting this to base 10. And I'll tell you the GME to use, although there are a lot of methods you can use in converting this to base 10. But I'm going to use the same method you are used to. And what is the method? You will look at how many digits do we have here? Count. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yes. Thank you. Coming to the last digit, which is 1. So you are going to assign values from 0 in increasing order. That's what we are going to do now. So, at the top of this one, you assign 0. After 0, in increasing order, in ascending order, we have 1, 2, 3. 0, 1, 2, 3. You're assigning that to this. Then how do we go about this? You are now starting from this. Let's start from here. You can decide to start from here. You can decide to start from here. Anyone that is convenient for you. But let's start from this first digit given to us here. You start with 1 times, what is the base? 2. Raised to power, what power do we have here? We have what? 3. Thank you. 3. You do what? You close the brackets. Then we proceed by moving to the second digit, which is 1 again. So you pick this 1 times 2. Raised to power, what power do we have there after 3? 2, right? Raised to power 2 plus. The third one, we have 0, right? We pick it, multiply by the base, which is what? 2. Raised to power, what power does it have? 1. Thank you. Plus 1 times, what is the base? 2. Raised to power, what is the power? 0. I hope you are getting it. Now, if you look at this, the powers, you have 0, 1, 2, 3. Just as I assigned it, 0, 1, 2, 3. So, let's continue. We have 1 times 2 raised to power 3 will give you what? 6? No, it can't be 6. Because when we talk about 2 raised to power 3, 2 times 2 times 2. 2 raised to the power 3 is the same as 2 times 2 times 2, which is what? 6. Is it 6? No, it is 8. So you have to take note of this. So when we say power, it's not addition, you are multiplying. I hope you understand that. Thank you. So 2 raised to the power 3 will give you what? 8. Good. Plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 2 means you are multiplying 2 in 2 places, which is 2 times 2, which will give you what? 4. Thank you. Plus 0 times 2 raised to the power 1 is the same as what? 2. Plus 1 times 2 raised to the power 0, who can tell me? 1, 0, 2, which one? 1, thank you. That means when inside you are multiplied, you are having something raised to the power, of 0 will give you what? 1. 20 raised to the power 0 will give you what? 1. 2 raised to the power 0 will give you what? 1. James raised to the power 0 will give you what? 1. Thank you. So here you are having 2 raised to the power 0 gives 1. Now let's continue with the multiplication. 1 times 8 will give you what? 8. 1 times 4 will give you what? 4. Plus 0 times 2 will give you what? 0. We know that from primary school, anytime anything multiplied by 0 will give what? 0. Plus 1 times 1 will give you what? 1. Now let's continue with addition. 8 plus 4 gives 12. 12 plus 0 gives 12. 12 plus 1 gives 13. So this gives 13. This is in base 10. You can decide to write this 10. You can decide to use no. Because anytime we're having number waiting without a base being indicated, it is generally assumed to be in base 10. I hope you understand. So that means if you convert 1, 1, 0, 1 in base 2, it will be equivalent to 13, not 13 this time around, 13 in base 10. It will be equivalent to what? 13 in base 10. I hope you understand that. Thank you. Now the second question, I want you to do this second question, which is converting 1, 1, 1, 1, 0 in base 2. You are converting this to base 10. So, you do this and put your answer in the comments section. I am going to mark it. And also, if you can't put it in the comment section, you can send it to our WhatsApp number 081-6293-7165. And if you are not in Nigeria, you can send it to +234-8162-93-7165. That is our WhatsApp number. I am going to go through it, mark it, and send it back to you. Thank you very much. Please don't forget to like our video and also subscribe to our channel. Thank you. See you next video. Have a wonderful day. Thank you very much.